नमस्कार। टुडे वी विल सी दी आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड एनाटॉमिकल पोजीशंस ऑफ डिफरेंट वर्टेब्री, दी सर्वाइकल वर्टेब्रा एंड वी कैन सी दी फोरामिना ट्रांसवर्स एरियम इन दी ट्रांसवर्स प्रोसेस, दिस इज दी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ दी सर्वाइकल वर्टेब्रा। देर आर 7 सर्वाइकल वर्टेब्री, द फर्स्ट, सेकेंड एंड सेवन आर एटिपिकल, वाइल थर्ड, फोर्थ, फिफ्थ एंड सिक्स आर टिपिकल। दिस इज दी टिपिकल सर्वाइकल वर्टेब्रा। दी बॉडी शुड बी एंटीरियर एंड दी स्पाइन शुड बी पोस्टीरियर, स्पाइन इज बाइफिड। दी सुपीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ बॉडी इज हैविंग एलिवेटेड लिप्स ऑन लैटरल साइड, दिस लिप्स शुड बी ऑन सुपीरियर एस्पेक्ट। सो दिस इज दी एनाटॉमिकल पोजिशन, दिस इज टिपिकल सर्वाइकल वर्टेब्रा। नाउ दिस इज दी फर्स्ट सर्वाइकल वर्टेब्रा, एटलास। इन केस ऑफ एटलास देर इज नो बॉडी, देर इज नो स्पाइन, बॉडी इज अब्सेंट, स्पाइन इज अब्सेंट। देर आर टू लैटरल मासेस, ऑन दी सुपीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ दी लैटरल मास देर इज ए elongated facet which is constricted in the middle, means it looks like kidney shaped facet. It should be on superior aspect. Now these two lateral masses are connected anteriorly by anterior arch and posteriorly by posterior arch. Anterior arch is smaller, posterior arch is larger. So we have to hold the bone in such a way that the superior articular facet should face superiorly, the smaller anterior arch anteriorly, larger posterior arch posteriorly. This is the first cervical vertebra, atlas. The second cervical vertebra is called as axis. This is the body. Body should be anterior, spine should be posterior. On the superior surface of the body there is tooth like process called as odontoid process. It should be on superior aspect. So this is the anatomical position of second cervical vertebra. It is called as axis. The seventh cervical vertebra is called as vertebra prominence. Body should be on anterior aspect, spine should be on posterior aspect. Spine is not bifid, it is forming a tubercle at the tip. The superior surface of body shows elevated lips on both sides, on lateral aspect. They should be on superior aspect. Superior surface is concave. So this is the anatomical position of the seventh cervical vertebra. It is called as vertebra prominence. Now we will see thoracic vertebrae. In case of thoracic vertebra, there is no foramina transverse arium. Instead of that, there are demi facets on either side of the body. Demi facets, half facets on either side of the body. The transverse and anteroposterior dimension of the body is equal. The upper margin of the lamina should face upward and medially. So hold the bone in such a way that body should be anterior, spine should be posterior. And the pre margin, upper margin of the lamina, thin margin, it should face upward and medially. This is the anatomical position. This is the typical thoracic vertebra. There are 12 thoracic vertebrae. The first one and last four are atypical, means first, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. They are atypical, while second to 8th, they are typical. In addition to the demi facets on the body, there is one facet, costal facet on the transverse process. This is the first thoracic vertebra on either side of the body near the upper margin there is a circular facet and near the lower margin there is demi facet on either side the transverse distance is more than the anteroposterior distance means the body is just like cervical vertebrae there is also a facet on the transverse process so this is the first thoracic vertebra hold the bone in such a way that body should be anterior spine should be posterior and the thin margin of the lamina should be upward and medially this is the ninth thoracic vertebra body should be anterior spine should be posterior thin margin of the lamina should be upward on the side of the body near the upper margin on either side there is a demi facet so this is the ninth thoracic vertebra this is the 10th thoracic vertebra there is one circular facet and this facet approach towards the pedicle on either side there is one circular facet hold the bone in such a way that body should be anterior spine should be posterior and the thin margin of lamina should be upward and medially there is presence of facet on the transverse process so this is the 10th thoracic vertebra this is the anatomical position this is the 11th thoracic vertebra and this one is 12th thoracic vertebra there is no facet on the transverse process the costal facet on transverse process is absent on either side of the body there is single facet near the upper margin encroaching on pedicle so this is 11th thoracic vertebra this one is 12th thoracic vertebra there is no facet on the transverse process there is no foramina transversarium there is single facet on the body and this facet encroaches on pedicle there is no costal facet on the transverse process instead of that there are three tubercles the superior tubercle represents mammillary process inferior tubercle represents accessory process and the lateral tubercle represents true transverse process so this is the 12th in case of 12th thoracic vertebra the inferior articular facet faces laterally inferior articular facet faces laterally and in case of 11th thoracic vertebra the facet faces forward the inferior articular facet in case of 11th thoracic vertebra faces forward while in case of 12th this inferior articular facet faces laterally so this is the most important point to distinguish 12th thoracic vertebra from the 11th on both of them there is no facet on the transverse process now we will see the lumbar vertebrae lumbar vertebrae are 5 in number the first second third and fourth are typical fifth is atypical This is the typical lumbar vertebra. The body is massive than the cervical or thoracic vertebrae. There is no foramina transversarium. There is no costal facet. Foramina transversarium is absent, means this is not cervical vertebra. Costal facet is absent, means this is not thoracic vertebra. The side to side distance is more than the anteroposterior distance in the body On the superior articular process, there is a tubercle, that is the mammillary tubercle, and on the posterior inferior aspect, we can see the accessory tubercle, and this is the transverse process. These are the superior articular facets. The distance between them is more than the distance between inferior articular processes. The distance between superior articular processes is more than the distance between inferior articular processes. This is the typical lumbar vertebra. Now we will see the fifth lumbar vertebra. This is the fifth lumbar vertebra. We can see that the transverse process encroaches on body. Transverse process encroaches on body, and secondly, the distance between superior articular processes is more or less equal to the distance between inferior articular processes. Transverse process encroaches on body. This is the anatomical position. The body should be anterior, spine should be posterior. There is no costal facet, there is no foramina transversarium. In case of the typical lumbar vertebra, the transverse process begins from the junction of pedicle and lamina. It is not encroaching on the body. While in case of fifth lumbar vertebra, the transverse process encroaches on the body, and the distance between superior and inferior articular processes is more or less equal. This is the sacrum. It is formed by the fusion of 5 sacral vertebrae, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the pelvic sacral foramina. This is the body. This is the upper end, body and ala. The upper end, the lower end is tapering, narrow. Upper broad end is at upper end, lower tapering end is at lower end. The pelvic surface should face downwards and forwards. Dorsal rough surface should face backward. And this is the upper end of sacral canal. It should face almost upward. Upper end of the sacral canal should face upward. So this is the anatomical position. Broad end superiorly, narrow tapering end inferiorly. The pelvic surface should face downward and forward, and the upper end of sacral canal should face upward. Thank you.